Look at that. Oh, my goodness.
They've got a pretty good kick on them. Can still get a good game.
A soccer match at DeepMind looks like fun and games, but here's the thing. Humans did not program these robots to play. They learned the game by themselves.
It's coming up with these interesting different strategies, different ways to walk, different ways to block.
And they're doing it. They're scoring over and over again.
This robot here.
Raya Hadsel, Vice President of Research and Robotics, showed us how engineers used motion capture technology to teach the AI program how to move like a human. But on the soccer pitch, the robots were told only that the object was to score. The self-learning program spent about 2 weeks testing different moves. It discarded those that didn't work, built on those that did, and created all-stars.
There's another goal.
And with practice, they get better. Hadsel told us that, independent from the robots, the AI program plays thousands of games from which it learns and invents its own tactics.
Here, you think that red player is going to grab it, but instead it just stops it, hands it back, passes it back, and then goes for the goal.
And the AI figured out how to do that on its
own. That's right. That's right. And it takes a while. At first, all the players just run after the ball together like a gaggle of, 6-year-olds the first time they're playing ball. Over time, what we start to see is now, what's the strategy? You go after the ball, I'm coming around this way, or we should pass, or I should block while you get to the goal. So we see all of that coordination emerging in the play.
This is a lot of fun, but what are the practical implications of what we're seeing here?
This is the type of research that can eventually lead to robots that can come out of the factories and work in other types of human environments. You know, think about mining, think about dangerous construction work, or exploration, or disaster recovery.